Madamo gid nga salamat sa tanan nga mga nagapamati, nagapadayon sa pagsunod sa aton program. Amon gid ginakalipay ang inyo mapinadayonon nga pagsuporta. Pinaagi sa bugay kag kaluoy sang Dios, kita nakapadayon sa sini nga programa. This time, ari kita sa ikatatlo nga topic entitled Repentance. Bago sina may sugilanon, nahanungod sa isa ka tawo, convicted, ginpamatbatan sang sala nga murder. Ang iya utod, may ara sang madamo nga hinimuan nga iya na presentar sa among state. Gani siya nagpakiluoy sa mga leader sa government, agod mahatagan pardon ang iya nga utod. After nga ara na ang among letter of pardon, nagkagto siya sa iya utod. Pero antes niya ipabasa ang among pardon, iya anay ginpamangkot ang iya utod. Brad, kung ikaw bi makagwa sa sininga prisuhan, ano ang una mo nga pagahimuon? Sa wala sang pag-alang-alang, ang ininga utod nagsabat, I will track down the judge who gave the sentence and I will murder him. Then, what's next? Then, I will track down the witnesses and still murder them. Ang iya utod, sa wala man sang pag-alang-alang, gintago na lang ang among letter of pardon kag nagtalikod sa iyang utod. After all, nga siya ginhatagan sang among pamatbat, waay sang pagbag-o sa iya tagipusoon. Another story we can get in the Bible was the story of David. After committing sin, the prophet Nathan used by God to confront him about his sin. And we know the story about it. After Nathan gave a short parable and saw the reaction of David, he told David, and you are the man. For David, after knowing his sins, he said to himself, I have sinned against the Lord. The record is found in 2 Samuel 12:13. The two story is so contrast. The other one did not feel his guilt and no chance of repenting what he had done. The other one, David, although he was confronted with that kind of judgment, felt that he have sinned against the Lord. And according to our Seventh-day Adventist Bible Dictionary, it says, the context shows that these words were spoken sincerely. So when David said, I have sinned, those words were spoken sincerely. Nathan's rebuke had gone straight to his heart. And David humbly confessed himself a sinner. Wow! What a wonderful reaction we have read. David humbly confessed himself a sinner. And in return to his repentant attitude, it was recorded in the book of Psalm 51. This is the expression of David, an expression of repentance. He said, have mercy on me, O God, according to your unfailing love. Yeah, you can see how David really knew his God. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your unfailing love, according to your great compassion. Blot out my transgression, wash away all my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgression, and my sin is always before me. Yeah, you can see that the sin that David had made always hunted him. That's why he pleaded to God to take those sins. Verse 4, against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are proved right when you speak and justified when you judge. Verse 7, again, David plead, cleanse me with hyssop, and I will be clean. Wash me, and I will be whiter than snow. Let me hear joy and gladness. Let the bones you have crushed rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot all my iniquity. And the famous verse we always recite, it says in verse 10, create in me a pure heart, O God. Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me from your presence, or take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of salvation, and grant me a willing spirit to sustain me. You see, the feelings, not just an expression, but the feeling, the conviction of King David, do not take your Holy Spirit from me. He knows that this Holy Spirit who is working in him will help him to be restored in God's sight. That's why in verse 11, in verse 12, restore to me the joy of salvation and grant me a willing spirit to sustain me. All this chapter of Psalm 51 was the expression of David's repentance. According to Vine's Expository Dictionary, about the word to repent, it means a change of heart or disposition. A change of heart or disposition. A change of mind. A change of purpose. Or an emphasis upon the change of one's conduct. So we can see, to repent is not just to say that you are sorry for your sin, but it is a change of heart. Not just heart or disposition, but also your mind will be changed of not doing anymore the sin that you have committed. And a change of purpose. And according to our book, Steps to Christ, it says that repentance includes sorrow for sin and turning away from it. Sorrow for sin and turning away from it. So the question, why do we need to repent? In Romans 3:23-24, it says that for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Because of our sins, we fall short of the glory of God. And according to Isaiah, our iniquities, our sins, is the one who is separating us from God, blocking us before the presence of God. Without repentance, we cannot be back with God. So repentance is a step we need to take in order to be back to God. In our local dialect, repentance is hinulsol. Paghinulsol. Ang paghinulsol, tikang agod nga kita mabalik sa Ginoo. Ato na nakita nga ang paghinulsol or repentance is a change of mind, not just a sorrow for sin, but turning away from it. Turning away from it. So, ang sala, imugid ginabayaan. In this direction, going to sin, repentance means turning away 180 degrees. Not 360. Because if you will do 360, still, you are on that direction again, doing that sin. Only 180 degrees turn. It means a total turning away. And another question is, but must the sinner wait till he has repented before he can come to Jesus? Kinahanglan ba nga ang usa ka tinuga, usa ka tawo, magliso usa, maghinulsol usa, aron makabalik kang Jesus? Is repentance to be made an obstacle between the sinner and the Savior? That's the question. If we will look at the parable that Jesus made in the gospel, the parable of the lost son, what made him realize of his situation? Nga nakarealisar siya sa iya sitwasyon during that time. Before, when he was in his father's side, bastante siya sa pagkaon. Now, away from his father, bisan pa ang pinakamalain nga pagkaon, bahog sa sapat nga dili matinlo, daw amuna ang ipakaon sa iya. And while in that circumstance, in that situation, it comes to his mind, wow, nami pa, mabalik ko sa akon amahan, sa akon amay. So the question, what makes him realize about it? It is because of the character of his father that brought him to think that he needs to be back to his father. Repentance is not a hindrance. But when we continue to look at Jesus Christ, His perfect character, there's no way for us to be go away with Him. Ang iya batasan nga aton ginatulok, aton ginapamalandungan, makita naton nga bangod sa iya nga paghigugma, gugma nga wala sang tupong, gugma nga hindi matungkad sang tawhanon nga pangunahuna, amo ang maga buyok sa aton palapit sa iya. It will draw us to Christ. And as we continue to look at His perfect character, we will see our sinfulness. And that will lead us to repentance. Kung hindi kita magpalapit sa iya, hindi naton makita ang aton pagkamakasasala, hindi kita makahinulsol. ang pamangkot, but must the sinner wait till he has repented before he can come to Jesus? Is repentance to be made an obstacle between the sinner and the Savior? The answer is no. Bisan wala ka pa makahinulsol, palapit ka kag palapit sa iya. Kag sa imo pagpadayon sa pagpalapit sa iya, makita mo ang imo madamo nga mga shortcomings, and you will see the grace extended to you by God that will lead you to repentance. Repentance is an answer to the working of the Holy Spirit. Ang paghinulsol, sabat sa pagpanghikot sa balaan ni Espiritu. Buot sing ganon, kung sige ka gihapon sa pagpamalandong, sa paghimo sang sala, ang Holy Spirit hindi makapangabudlay sa imo. But when you look at Jesus Christ, His love, His suffering, all that is in Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit will continue to work in you and you will yield your life to the working of the Holy Spirit according to the steps of Christ. But when the heart yields to the influence of the Spirit of God, the conscience will be quickened. Again, I will repeat. But when the heart yields to the influence of the Spirit of God, the conscience will be quickened. And the sinner will discern something of depth and sacredness of God's holy law, the foundation of His government in heaven and on earth. Bangod gali sa pagpanghikot sa balaan ng Espiritu, ang makasasala, makabatyag, makakita, makahangup sang kadalom sang pagkabalaan sang kasuguan sang Diyos nga amo ang pundasyon sang iya pang gobyerno sa langit kag sa duta. Di ko makita mo nga ang kasuguan balaan nga imo ginlapas, makita mo nga ang imo kinabuhi nagpalayo sa Ginoo. Kag kun magpalayo ka sa Ginoo, wala sang may magpanghikot sa imo, your attitude and character will not be changed. Steps of Christ, page 26. We can no more repent without the Spirit of Christ to awaken the conscience than we can be pardoned without Christ. Kinanglang gali, palapit kita. Kay kung hindi kita magpalapit dira sa Ginoo, ang Espiritu hindi man makapanghikot agud, makabatyag kita o kung makamata kita sa ginahimo naton nga sala. We can no more repent without the Spirit of Christ to awaken the conscience than we can be pardoned without Christ. So bisan bugat, damo ako sang sala, may mga kaluyahon ako, may mga ginahakwat pa ako ng mga lulan, kinahanglan ko magpalapit dira kay Kristo, palapit nga palapit, sunod nga sunod, agod sa sige ko, lantaw nga lantaw sa iya, then my conscience will be awakened. And in Christ alone, we can be pardoned from all our sins. The sinner may resist this love, may refuse to be drawn to Christ, but if he does not resist, he will be drawn to Jesus. A knowledge of the plan of salvation will lead him to the foot of the cross in repentance for his sins, which have caused the sufferings of God's dear Son. Ti amo na siya matabo. The sinner may resist this love, may refuse to be drawn to Christ, but if he does not resist, he will be drawn to Jesus. Sa sige niya tulok nga tulok kay Ginoong Hesus, sa gugma ni Ginoong Hesus, siya mabuyok palapit, drawn to Jesus Christ. And while in Jesus Christ, a knowledge of the plan of salvation will lead him to the cross, to the foot of the cross, in repentance for his sins, which have caused the sufferings of God's dear Son. A little girl, as he noticed, when he goes out from his house every day, during that time, he saw that the statue was so dirty. May mga lumot, may mga yabok. Pagkasunod nga adlaw the next day, people try to clean the statue. And as she reflect the statue to herself, he saw also his uncleanness. Bisan pa sa iya bisti daw, hindi siya na namian magtulok. So she told her mother, "Mother, please change my clothes. Paliguin ko." Okay. The next day, as he went out to her house, he saw again that the statue was being repainted. Oh, bag-una, nami na ang pinta. Again, she told her mom, "Mom, again, please change my clothes." Whatever he saw, whatever she saw, the development being done to that statue, she tried to reflect to herself. Now, the statue was so enormous. And when we look that little child, she reflect the beauty of that statue. Nagnami ang istatwa, nagnami man ang yetsura. When we are drawn to the foot of the cross, we will see Jesus Christ, and that will change our mind going to repentance of the sins that we have made. So mga hinigugma, kinahanglan naton magtulok kay Jesus Christ. Follow Jesus Christ so that our attitude, our character will be changed. You see your sinfulness. Do not wait to make yourself better. How many there are who think they are not good enough to come to Christ? They expect to become better through your own efforts? So the question, can the Ethiopian change his skin or the leopard his spots? Then may ye also do good that are accustomed to do evil. Jeremiah 13:23. There is help for us only in God. We must not wait for stronger persuasions, for better opportunities, or for boiler tempers. We can do nothing of ourselves. We must come to Christ just as we are. Di na ta maghulat nga magbalaan ta. Di na ta maghulat nga magsiling ta nga baw, ari nang akon pagkabala. No. We must come to Jesus Christ just as we are. Kay siya amo ang maga change sang aton kinabuhi. We have no power against it. Can the Ethiopian change his skin? No. The leopard his spots? No. But through the power of Jesus Christ, through his character, sa aton pagtulok, we may be changed. And in 2 Corinthians 5:17, "Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new." So we need just to come to Jesus Christ so that our old self will be done away and now the new self. Every act of transgression, every neglect or rejection of the grace of Christ is reacting upon yourself. It is hardening the heart, depraving the will, benumbing the understanding, and not only making you less inclined to yield, but less capable of yielding to the tender pleading of God's Spirit. So, instead of continuing sinning, change your track. Even one wrong trait of character, one sinful desire, persistently cherish, will eventually neutralize all the power of the gospel. Every sinful indulgence strengthens the soul's aversion to God. The man who manifests an infidel, hardihood, or a stolid indifference to divine truth is but reaping the harvest of that which he has himself sown. So, my dear brothers and sisters, do not go against the Spirit. When the Holy Spirit try to convict you, try to wake you up of the sins that you have committed, don't go against the Holy Spirit. As you see the enormity of sin, as you see yourself, as you really do not give up to despair. It was the sinners that Christ came to save. We have not to reconcile God to us, but, O wondrous love, God in Christ is reconciling the world unto Himself. So you see, brothers and sisters, when you see your sinfulness, we need to go to Jesus Christ. And when Satan comes to tell you that you are a great sinner, look up to your Redeemer and talk of His merits. That which will help you is to look to His light. Acknowledge your sin, but tell the enemy that Christ came into this world to save sinners like you and me, and that you may be saved by His matchless love. It is the work of Satan. Sometimes siya nagapanghikot sa imo, you will be weakened when you look back to your past. Wow, amo ko ni kakawatan, amo ko ni kamakasasala, amo ko ni sangunay, hindi na ko mag-alagad. But look up to your Redeemer. Kay ang imo sala, iya na naginbayaran. You are now free to live against it. Just follow Jesus Christ so that you will have a character like Him. A story I have read about Robert Robinson. You know, Robert Robinson was the author of the hymn entitled, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing. It is here in our church hymnal, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing. But this man, Robert Robinson, have lost the happy communion with the Savior he had once enjoyed. Siguro natalaka naman siya sa pagkinabuhi. Now he tried to live just what he wants. So in order for him to have that simple life, in his later life, he wondered and tried to have a trouble, hoping to relieve his mind. So he decided to travel. One day, In the course of his journey, he became acquainted with a woman. And this woman, somewhat a religious woman. And she asked him what he thought of a hymn she had just been reading. Robert did not know that this woman had just read the song or the poem he just wrote. To his astonishment, he found it to be none other than his own compilation. Nabalaan niya, iyagali ito. Siya itong nagimo. Trying to evade, try to change topic. But still the woman tried to ask him kung ano ang iya ihambal about that song. Suddenly, he began to weep. Robert Robinson began to weep. With tears streaming down his cheeks, he said, "I am the man who wrote that. I am the one who wrote that hymn. Years ago, I am the one who composed and wrote that hymn. And during that time, I'd give anything to experience again the joy I know them." Although greatly surprised, she reassured him that the streams of mercy mentioned in his song still flowed. Nalipay man siya. He was reminded by that lady by sharing what she read, a hymn. Brothers and sisters, the streams of mercy never cease. How dirty we are, how sinful we are, how great a sinner we are. If we come to Jesus Christ, He will not deny you. Come to Him. And by coming to Him, He will say to you, "Your sins are forgiven." Sincerely, if you repent, your sins are forgiven. Then, go and sin no more. That is repentance. We are not perfect. We have limitations. We have a lot of personal struggles made daily. But when we fall, rise up. Go back to Jesus Christ, your only hope. Confess and repent your sins, and you will be forgiven. It is my prayer that all of us will be cleansed from all unrighteousness and will be with that group of people redeemed when Jesus Christ will come upon this earth. Let us pray. Loving God, we would like to thank you for your great love. Even though how sinful we are, even though we wandered away from you, you still send Jesus Christ to seek and to save us. So we come to you, dear Lord, asking for the working of the Holy Spirit so that the sins we have committed against you will not be made again. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, we will overcome all of them. And thank you for the Holy Spirit that He will present us before the Father through Jesus Christ, forgiven. We claim for your promise that we will, when we confess our sins, you are faithful and true to accept us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So thank you, dear Lord, for helping all who are listening right now, helping them to overcome the sins, the secret sins, the hidden sins they have, and they will walk in the right path of righteousness, walking with you, having the steps for Jesus Christ. Thank you, dear Lord, for hearing our prayer. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless us all, everyone.
Because